Blessed night, everyone. Welcome back to Reading with Third Sky 101 Bible Bedtime Stories. Today we will be reading Abraham is Tested. By the graphic of the image, it looks a little bit, to me, I'm not liking the image very well. You know, I'm sure if you guys see it, I don't think you're gonna like it as well, but you know, I'm sure there's a good outcome. I haven't read it yet, but I see an angel, so I'm assuring there's going to be a great outcome. So, let's get into it and see what this Abraham is Tested is about. And for those of you who have the book, please turn to page 20 and 21. Alright guys, bear with me. Like I said, if I mess up a little, I will rephrase my words. I am reading it along as I just opened my book. Hope you guys had a wonderful day and are nice and snuggly and having a wonderful night. Alright, let's get started. It says, Abraham is tested. It says, Abraham and his wife Sarah were very old before they had the baby God had promised them. Isaac grew up to be a fine young boy, and his parents loved him dearly. But one day, God decided to test Abraham, saying he must offer the boy as a sacrifice. Abraham was heartbroken, but he trusted God. So he prepared to do as he had been told. He took his son up the mountain and built an altar. But as he picked up his knife, an angel cried, Abraham, do not harm the boy. I know that you love God with all your heart, for you were willing to give up your son. God sent a ram to be sacrificed instead, and he told Abraham that he would bless him and his family because of Abraham's faith. Oof. Oof. This one was tiny bit graphic in my opinion. But at least there was a beautiful outcome. And yes, guys, now let's get into it for tonight. I believe, yes, it's true. God does test us. And yes, we should listen to his voice and trust in God. There is times where he tests us. As a matter of fact, right now as we speak, there is brothers and sisters of the Lord being tested today. Around the world, everywhere. But we have to listen to his voice, you know. We have to be faithful servants of God. And you know, if he told us to do something like this, you know, if it's just a test, somehow he's going to send an angel or his own voice to tell us, don't do it. It was a test. And then, you know, he's going to tell us how he's going to bless us for being so faithful to him and willing to give up whatever he told us to do or whatever the task was, you know, or whatever test he's putting you through. But yes, my little boys and girls, in tonight's story, it's pretty much telling us that we should learn to accept God's tests, even if they seem hard. Because if it's the test, he's going to tell you, in other words, stop, don't do it. And then he's going to bless you for being servant, you know, a faithful servant. But yes, guys, that's what I learned of tonight's story. Thank you guys, you know, for keep tuning in with me. I really appreciate you guys. And like I said, if you guys don't have, you know, somebody to read you a bedtime story, well, here I am, you know. I am reading it to those of you or anybody really who wants to read along with me. I don't mind. The more the merrier. It's fun, you know. But yeah, guys, thank you very much for tuning in. Now let's pray. And I hope you guys have a wonderful night. All right, let's put the book down. All right. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, thank you for letting us read this wonderful story. It was slightly graphic, but as we could see, Abraham passed the test. And in tonight's prayer, I'm going to ask you to please and thank you help every single one of us. Anybody, Father, any age, even these lovely children. If you once put us through a test, help us pass this test, Father. Please let us be these faithful servants. We want to be your faithful servants. Please help us, Father, so you may bless us after we pass that horrible test trial that you're going to put us through, or you're putting somebody out there through. Just know that God is going to lift us up. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, thank you for lifting us up and taking us out of this horrible situation we're in. Whoever's in a horrible situation. And whoever's sick, Father, thank you for healing them and helping them. In the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we love you and we praise you. Please let all of us, Father, have a wonderful night. Thank you for being in control, Father, of this beautiful story. Thank you for being in control of our lives. Please take control of our lives and help us be faithful servants to you and pass your tests. We love you and we praise you, Father. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. But yeah, guys, thank you very much for tuning in. I appreciate you guys very much for tuning in. And as I said, you know, please and thank you, share with your little friends or anybody out there, you know. You guys know their parents don't have time to read bedtime stories to them, you know, or anything like that, you know. I will be the one reading to you, which I'm reading to myself as well, since I never got that as a child. But thank you guys for tuning in. Much love and much respect. Thank you all for being good sports. And good night. Bye.